Personally, I think I use stream provider much more often than future provider, especially in the case of Firebase, which is often used in Flutter apps. It actively uses streams. First, what are you reminded of when you think of a stream, as in continuous feature values? If a program continuously sends battery levels every 10 seconds, then the continuous value of those battery levels is a stream. Another example would be stock market indices. The stock market index is continuously updated and displayed throughout the day. Flutter has something called Stream Builder that can handle these values. However, if you want to access the stream value from multiple widgets, it is more convenient to use a stream provider. And there is one thing in common between stream provider and future provider. That is, just as a future provider uses a future value as its type, stream provider also uses a continuous future values type as its type. Now, let's create an app that will apply stream provider. In this example, we will test a stream provider by slightly modifying the Provider Overview 06 app. Let's start by creating an app called the Provider Overview 07 and copying all the contents of Provider Overview 06. We will create a bulk function that generates a string type stream. The bulk function yields a string called the bulk iTimes every 2 seconds, as much as the number of age that was passed through the constructor. Go to main.dart and create a string type stream provider under future provider. Read the age of dog instance in create callback and store it in a variable called dogAge. The dog instance can be read through context.read because it has already been created in changing notifier higher up in the widget tree. Create a babies object where the age is dogAge times 2 and store it in the babies variable. And the important thing here is that you need to return babies.bark, not babies. And we will give bark 0 times for initial data, the required argument. Give a height 10.0 size box to make some space between this widget and the next widget. This text widget outputs the number of bucks. But remember that the return type of string provider was a string. Therefore, in context.watch, string must be given as a type. And the font size will be 20.0. Let's run it after doing a hard restart. Starting from initial data bark 0 times, the value changes every 2 seconds. As a result, the 6 times from 0 to 5 were displayed normally. But before we move on, let's do some experimentation. Stream provider reads the age value through context.read, but what happens if I change it to context.watch? Let's do a hard restart. An error occurred. Let's read the error message. It says, life cycle, they will never be called again. Create was only called once. Therefore, looking at this, logically, it's not right to use watch. Let's change back read to watch and give read instead of watch in the part that outputs bark iTimes and do a hard restart. There was no change, although time has passed. This is the obvious result you get when you use read, since it doesn't listen for changes. Let's change read back to watch and move on to the next section. In the next section, we will learn about the consumer widget.